We are here to present a check of 300 million naira to the 300 orphans.
The check is now being presented for 300 million naira. Can we give a round of applause for His Excellency Governor Mwetoseyi, Governor Italakawa?
Governor Babagana Umaru Zulum started his engagements for the month of November with the award of scholarship to 300 orphaned children of slain civilian JTF, vigilante and hunters while fighting Boko Haram. The first phase of the scholarship scheme, according to Governor Zulum, will engulf 300 million naira to cover educational needs of the orphans throughout their basic education level.
Let me also assure you that the far-reaching recommendations made will be implemented immediately for these orphans to get enrolled into the various schools of their choices. And this program will continue to exist, inshallah, during my tenure as the governor of Borno State.
Aside the scholarship, Professor Babagana Umara added, government has approved livelihood support of 1.5 million naira to mothers and guardians of the 300 orphans, with each getting 50,000 naira, a bag of rice and maize. Governor Zulum equally announced the increase of monthly allowance of security volunteers from 20,000 naira to 30,000 naira.
Government is also announcing end of year bonus to all of you amounting to your 1 month salary of 20,000 naira. Let me once again commend the effort of the committee for working assiduously with the appointed time to come up with these workable recommendations for the smooth take-up of this scholarship award.
Muna farin ciki da wannan taimako da gwamnati wa marayu na farko ya taimaka musu da abin da zasu ci da kuma dawainiyar makarantansu. Wannan abin farin ciki ne ga mu lidodi da muke jagoran jama'a, wanda a yau idan yaki ya faru aka yi rashi ko jin haka iyayen yara ba za su yi bakin ciki da faruwar mutuwan ɗansu ba, za su ji daɗi da wannan gudunmawa da aka yi musu. Domin da inda uba yake dama na farko ya ɗauki ɗawainiyar yaro wajen makaranta da abin da zai ci ya sha.
Also in the month of November, Governor Babagana Umaru Zulum has inaugurated a review committee of the primary school teachers verification exercise conducted in December 2020. The earlier committee had evaluated 26,450 teachers on government's payroll, out of which 7,794 teachers were identified as ghost workers. Based on the report, 624 teachers were believed to have been wrongly included in the ghost workers list, and the Borno State branch of the Nigeria Union of Teachers, NUT, lodged a complaint which necessitated the inauguration of the review committee. Governor Zulum, who is a teacher and passionate about education, constituted the review committee, which has the Secretary to the State Government as chairman, Commissioner for Local Government and Emirate Affairs Vice Chairman, together with representatives of the NUT, NOLGE, and other relevant officials.
The mandate of this committee, among others, is to re-examine the previous reports, whether we have those that are inadvertently or knowingly affected by this committee. Those that are found not guilty are to be reinstated.
The review committee is mandated to thoroughly review identities of the 624 persons listed by the NUT and the report submitted earlier to the government on the verification and biometric data capture of local government staff and local education authorities.
A dummy check of 320 million naira from His Excellency the Executive Governor for his members.
Similarly, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umaru Zulum dispersed 814 million naira to 9,154 micro, small and medium enterprises, MSMEs, to stimulate local businesses under the Borno COVID-19 Action Recovery and Economic Stimulus Program, codenamed Borno Cares. Borno Cares is Borno State's domestication of the federal government's NG Cares to mitigate the impact of COVID-19 pandemic on the poor and vulnerable households, as well as small-scale enterprises. Borno Cares, Governor Zulum explained, is also geared towards addressing youth restiveness to the barest minimum.
This magnanimous program, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, is geared towards providing soft loans amounting to 719,200,000 to 9,100 small businesses owners through NG Cares Results Area 3. While 95 million naira shall be dispersed directly to the poor beneficiaries, due to the nature of their businesses, cannot be dispersed through NG Cares Results, making a grand total of 814,200,000 to be dispersed under NG Cares Results and Direct Disbursement this morning. You may understand that most of the beneficiaries of this support are the youths, and youths are the backbone of every society. Hence, we are there empowering them to be self-reliant in return.
4,024 tricycle operators selected through the Amalgamated Union of NAPEP Riders, 3,130 mobile phone repairers and retailers under the Borno State Association of GSM Operators, and 2,000 tailors from the Borno State Tailoring Association benefited from the program.
Borno State Association GSM Operators, Gumna Dero Maskera Dia Vilena, Adia Ngawen Gozi, Kumayro Adia Gozi, Jamani Sama Soa Banajin Gozina Ebana Zinae, Uru Amdu Yakin, Unyen Tiakin Kumayro Adia Banajis, Adia Roba Kumuna Dachina, Shuru Maskera Dia Vilena.
Excellency, Kaga Halim Davide Chiki, Kaga Halim Davide Chiki,
of the transportation of cattle from the Borongara to the Maiduguri to the glory of God and to the benefit of God.
Also in the month of November, Professor Babagana Umaro Zulum was in Gambaru, a border town close to Cameroon Republic, where he reopened the Gambaru International Cattle Market, trans-border commercial hub between Nigeria, Cameroon, and the Republic of Chad, which was closed for 7 years due to Boko Haram insurgency. Governor Zulum, who was delighted, expressed gratitude to President Muhammadu Buhari, the military, police, customs and immigration services, the Department of State Security, and other security agencies for liberating and securing the area, which made it possible for reopening the market. Professor Babagana Umara, however, warned against aiding, abetting, or participating in any form of criminality in the market to jeopardize the successes recorded, saying, whoever is found wanting will face the wrath of the law.
The transportation of cattle has to be conducted under a very serious protocol. The Nigerian Army and other security agencies will read the Riot Act
to all those that are involved in this business. Wherever I found wanting, the discharge of his duty shall be dealt accordingly.
While in Gambarungala, he continued his humanitarian support of distributing food items, textile materials and cash amounting to 250 million naira to 70,000 vulnerable households in Ngala, Gambaru and Wulgur. The state government, Professor Babagana Umara Zulum, said the communities had experienced flooding, which denied them access to their farmland, hence the intervention to ease their hardship, assured of continued support until they're able to stand on their feet.
The communities have experienced flooding. That's one of the reasons why we came. And the second reason why we came here is that still some couldn't have access to their farmlands. And that has necessitated the intention of the government of Borno State to come and continue with the distribution of food and non-food items to the displaced communities. But I'm happy to note that 95% of the population of Borno State have farmed this year. So we shall continue to provide food and non-food items to the few people, to the few remaining people that are yet to get access to their farmlands. That's the main reason why we are here.
The president in waiting on the...
Also during the month under review, Governor Zulum was in Jos, the Plateau State capital, for the flag off of the All Progressives Congress presidential campaign. The rally, which was well attended by stakeholders, party members and loyalists across the country, led by President Muhammadu Buhari, supported by the APC National Chairman, Senator Abdullahi Adamu, and the Progressive Governors, presented the party flag to the APC presidential candidate Bola Ahmed Tinubu and his running mate, Senator Kashim Shettima, which signals the beginning of campaign nationwide. President Muhammadu Buhari expressed confidence in the return of the party to power in 2023, saying the party is lucky to have Bola Ahmed Tinubu and Kashim Shettima as its presidential candidate and running mate, respectively.
I'm just going to hand over the flag to Ahmed Bola Tinubu and wish us, which is all of our members, the best of luck in the next year.
Also in the month of November, Governor Babagana Umaru Zulum has received the Sultan of Sokoto, Muhammadu Saad Abubakar, who is in the ancient city of Maiduguri for the famous Barewa Old Boys Association Boba annual lecture, dinner and award ceremony. Also at the airport to receive the Sultan is His Eminence, the Sheikh of Borno, Alhaji Abubakar Ibn Umar Garbe Alamin Al-Kanmi, and top government officials in accordance with Borno hospitality. Ahead of their engagements, the Barewa Old Boys Association Boba, led by its national president, Engineer Tahir Ibrahim, in company of the state chairman, Muhammad Ibrahim Soho, and officials, paid a courtesy visit to Governor Babagana Umara and appreciated him for his hospitality and support in hosting the Boba annual event for the first time in the state.
Let me first and foremost use this opportunity to welcome you to Borno State. We are delighted to have you in our midst for your this year's annual lecture. And in particular, we are pleased to note the presence of His Eminence, the Sultan of Sokoto. Borno State is home of peace and hospitality. This is an opportunity for us to listen and hear from you, which is very important, because words of elders are words of wisdom. More so, the title of this year's lecture is very important to my humble self. members of my state executive councils, senators and members of House of Representatives, and all other senior civil servants, especially permanent secretaries and others, heads of MDS, are directed to attend this very important function.
Similarly, the Borno State Governor attended the Borewa Old Boys Association annual lecture, describing it as all-inclusive, and thanked Boba officials for choosing Borno for the 2022 event.
The topic of this year's lecture, Challenges of Leadership and Governance, is not just apt and relevant, but significantly germane to our current democratic setting, as the country is going through myriads of leadership challenges, largely characterized by pervasive and widespread insecurity, endemic poverty, pervasive unemployment, and youth restlessness, among others, of which requires a decisive, firm, and extraordinary resourceful leadership. Such leadership challenges, but also to mobilize and channel our vast natural resources towards the growth and development of the nation in an inclusive and all-encompassing manner. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the initiative of the Borewa All Boys Association to organize such an important event is highly commendable and worthy of emulation because of its strategic relevance to contemporary national issues.
This is the first time Borno is hosting such an occasion. Borewa All Boys Association. We welcome you to Borno, home of peace and home of hospitality. And inshallah, we don't have any doubt in our mind that the ceremony will be peaceful and successful here. We sincerely thank to His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Borno State, Professor Babagana Zuma, for all what he has been doing to the people of Borno. It's practical. It's nothing hidden. So we thank him very much. He has been touring local government from local government, community by community, villages by villages, distributing food and food items, caring for the people. May Allah reward you.
The guest speaker and the Sultan of Sokoto, Muhammad Saad Abubakar, in a paper titled The Challenges of Leadership and Governance in Nigeria, Looking Inwards and Falling Back on Indigenous Resources, said, no government is perfect. However, he urged leaders to be just in whatever they're doing.
While no government is perfect, leaders must endeavor to keep institutions on their toes so that they achieve that purpose of government: justice, peace, and development. The problem today in our great country, Nigeria, is that this good governance is becoming increasingly elusive, as a result of which despair and frustration are gradually setting in and building up to levels that threaten the stability of our society. It is in this spirit of our responsibility as leaders that I wish to draw our attention to these increasing trends and the need to take some extraordinary measures to address them before they overwhelm us completely.
The Chairman Board of Trustees of Borewa Old Boys Association, General Yakubu Gawan, retired represented, said, the choice of Borno as venue of the occasion was to project the resilience of government and people of Borno, acknowledge that peace has returned to Borno due to doggedness of Governor Babagana Umar Azulum.
Since the creation of the All Boys Association more than 80 years ago, occasions of Borewa have been taking place in various parts of this country. But never before has anything like this happened in the entire Northeast sub-region. Today, it is happening in Maiduguri. Having said that, I think the most qualified to welcome you all here is His Excellency the Governor of Borno himself. I will tell you why. This hall and all the decoration, the speaker system, everything you see here, our guests that have been accommodated and fed was done by His Magnanimity. We have no words to express our gratitude to him.
A gala night and dinner was organized to spice up their engagement in Maiduguri with award to deserving alumni of Boba, while sumptuous meals and royalty interlude from the cultural troupe entertained guests. Governor Zulum rounded off his engagements for the month of November with the inauguration of the APC State Campaign Council ahead of the 2023 general election. Addressing party loyalists at the multipurpose hall, Government House, Professor Zulum said his administration, by Allah's grace, succeeded in fulfilling most of the campaign promises he made during the 2019 governorship campaigns, and is sure to do more after his mandate renewal in 2023, inshallah.
I give thanks to Almighty Allah, the creator and the giver of life, whose mercies have held us to this point where I stand today to once again ask for the opportunity to serve the good people of Borno State as the governor. Today, by the grace of the Almighty Allah, we kept our promises to you and delivered the dividends of democracy as should be. We are here fully convinced that we can do more, inshallah. And clearly more will be done. That is why I ask all of you, the good people of Borno State, businessmen, women, youths, associations, friends and families, to join us in making the next phase of Borno transformation legacy. Of the promises we made before, inshallah, we are able to deliver thousands of houses and shelter for our people. We were able to reach and support consistently over 2.7 million people with food, funds, and facilities to make their lives more meaningful. We built more roads in different areas of Borno State. We built more schools, hospitals, police posts, markets, and many more. We promise improvement in security, and by the grace of Almighty Allah, everyone can objectively verify that indeed the security situation has improved significantly. We are not going to rest on our oars. We plan to continue on this path of progress to consolidate the gains of the last few years of our stewardship.
He thanked the people of Borno for the support and understanding, saying, The APC will continue on its progressive development agenda to consolidate the gains of nearly 4 years of his stewardship. Professor Babagana Umara also spoke on issues surrounding the campaign visit of the PDP presidential candidate Alhaji Atiku Abubakar and reiterated his stance against political thuggery before, during, and after elections. Thank you.